Facebook has been used to reconnect with old friends and family.
But a former crime scene investigator used the social networking service as actually a crime-fighting tool.
Photojournalist Frank Burt has her story and shows us how she recovered a stolen scooter.
The day I woke up on that Monday morning and I walked outside and nothing but my helmet was there. I was very upset. I couldn't believe it. I'm a former crime scene investigator with the sheriff's office, so I'm used to being on the other side of these, you know, situations and helping people. And so to have my scooter stolen, I was surprised. I was shocked and I was definitely upset. Talked to my friends who've been teaching me about Facebook. I haven't been a big fan in the past, to be honest with you. And they said, post it. So I did, and it went crazy from there. Everybody rallied around, and other friends posted. It was reposted I don't even know how many times, and people were leaving their jobs and going to find it. We went and did a stakeout. We posted who wants to do a stakeout, and people submerged onto, you know, we met up at a market. We mapped it out. We turned right on Cimarron, and he was coming the other direction, around the median, around the side, and pulls up right behind him and called 911, waited for them. They told us not to get out of the car, so I was on the phone with dispatch, and we've got the iPhones out. They're taking them down right
now. Nice.
Sweet.
Nice, that's awesome.
Knocked at the guy?
No, I didn't say anything. He knew he just got busted by a bunch of women who channeled their inner Cagney and Lacey.
Robin needed her scooter so she could take part in this event. It's a breast cancer fundraiser. It's called Scooters for Hooters. It's going to take place tomorrow. The event is a 20-mile ride through Thornton Park, Baldwin Park, and Winter Park.
From local